Black Sails the Ghost Ship is a point-and-click adventure game from Deck 13 Interactive. This is the studio that brought you Venetica and Jack Keane. They have a very eclectic catalog, but they do have some experience in this genre. Most recently, they developed the Dark Souls-esque action RPG Lords of the Fallen. Deck 13 is a German-based company who seem to be unafraid to experiment. Let's take a look at their latest game. In Black Sails the Ghost Ship, you walk around a ship in a 3D environment. Most of the game is spent interacting with different objects. There are many puzzles throughout the game. In true point-and-click fashion, they require you to use and combine the various objects that you find in order to solve them. Unfortunately, sometimes it can be hard to figure out what to do next. Progression isn't always that intuitive. That isn't necessarily a huge criticism, though. I could see that being a selling point for some people as it increases the difficulty. There are also dialogue options for you to choose from. Some of these dialogue options are choices that will have an impact on the outcome of the game. One choice in particular has some heavy weight. There's really only one method of control in the game, and that's the mouse. You use the mouse to move, you click to interact with things, you drag to combine objects. The entire game can be played without a keyboard. Movement with the WASD keys would have been nice. It can be a bit clumsy to move by clicking on the ground. Simplicity does mean that the learning curve is pretty shallow, though. This is a very accessible game. When I looked at the options, I noticed something weird. It's a bit strange that the only graphic setting that you can change is anti-aliasing. You can turn it off, or choose x2 or x4. Aside from that, there's nothing. The graphics themselves are okay. They aren't anything particularly special. The character models aren't very good when you see them up close. That means the lip-sync can look a bit strange and the animations can be a bit robotic. On the other hand, environmental graphics are pretty nice. It really captures the idea of a ghost ship quite well. It's a strange juxtaposition when looking at the difference between the character models and their environment. I can't really fault it too much, because it doesn't detract heavily from the experience of playing the game. There's a nice soundtrack to add to the ambience. It isn't all that memorable, but the tracks are nice and add to the atmosphere. It's what you would expect from a game trying to spook you. Screeching music during scenes that are supposed to be intense, strange sounds that keep you on your toes. There's a lot of ambient noise that actually makes you feel like you're exploring a ship at sea. It gives a bit more immersion. The voice acting isn't good, but it's not horrible either. There are some lines that are delivered pretty poorly, and other times where it's done well. It's a bit hit or miss. The story is fairly simple. When you start the game, your ship has crashed at sea in a storm. The main character, Anna, survives by staying afloat on a log with a man named Lex. Now Anna and Lex have climbed aboard a strange ship that happened to be passing by, and they have to figure out a way to get to land. All the while, strange things are happening aboard the spooky ship. The story is delivered in a few ways, through dialogue with Lex, finding various notes and diaries, and through visions. The visions don't happen until later and are heavily spoilable, so I won't mention much about those. I will say that I found them to be the most interesting part of the game. There is a problem with the notes. They're done in a font that is pretty annoying to have to read. The letters are small, even on my 23-inch monitor at full screen 1080p resolution, and they're in cursive. This could have been dealt with fairly easily by using an overlay and normal print. The notes are pretty frequent as well, so it was a bit of a chore to read through them as they were presented. The story of the ship is a nice mystery, though, and it will keep you going to see what will happen next. One of the main problems I had with the game is one that's a staple of point-and-click games, finding what objects go where and finding the objects in the first place. There are moments where it definitely feels like you're going on a pixel hunt. I was stuck on one point in particular where I had to find a lockpick in order to progress. The only clue was that I needed to open a lock, and there's no way of knowing what you need to use for this. I had opened locks in multiple different ways previously, so it could have been any number of objects. Usually, you can use the help button on the bottom left, and it'll highlight things in the room. This object wasn't highlighted, and it's probably the only object in the entire game that isn't. So, I ran around the ship for around 30 minutes not knowing what to do. I find that a bit frustrating, but maybe others who are more into the genre won't. There are a few bugs that I experienced while playing the game. Most of them consisted of the character model clipping through different parts of the environment, sometimes to hilarious effect. I even went through the floor at one point, which was very strange. They weren't game-breaking though, and that's the important thing. This game isn't the best that you'll play this year. It certainly isn't groundbreaking. It does offer a good amount of fun, and I found it to be decently compelling. It also doesn't take that long to get through, clocking in at around 3 to 5 hours of content. Whenever I solved the puzzles in the game, I felt very satisfied. If you're a fan of the point-and-click genre, this is a game that will interest you. If you don't like these kinds of games, then it's unlikely that this game will change your mind. I enjoyed my time with it, and I think that if you give the game a chance, you will too. You can buy it now on Steam for $7.50 on sale, and $10 normally. I've been Melchioris from GameClouds. Have a good night, friends.